Hello, faithful, and welcome to a new edition of White Throne Metal Radio's Top 10 Songs. I'm your host, Kevin Crothers, station manager for White Throne Metal Radio, staff writer for Heaven's Metal Magazine. You can find links to both in the comments below. We play Christian rock and Christian metal 24 hours a day on White Throne Metal Radio, and you can check out all the latest and greatest over on Heaven's Metal Magazine, as well as heavensmetalmagazine.com. So today I want to talk to you about a band and an artist who really classic Christian rock artist, CCM artist, Mylon Lefevre, or Lefevre, I've always said Mylon Lefevre, and Broken Heart. Mylon Lefevre. It wasn't always with Broken Heart, but we're going to talk about the stuff between 1980 and the 1990. If you want to get all the biographical and background on Mylon, you can definitely do so. There are a lot of other websites and things that are probably much better equipped than I. This is not designed to be some kind of scholarly review. These are my favorite Mylon songs. And honestly, except for the top two or three, they're all pretty, a lot of these songs are pretty interchangeable to me, so don't get hung up on where they place on my list. So, but I will say this, there's actually, I'm calling kind of a mulligan. I'd say top 10, but I really have like 11 or 12, I think. What do I got? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11. Could actually say 12, so I'm just going to pick the bottom two. I could say honorable mentions, but one of those songs really, no. So, top 12 today. Mylon, you know, if you're not familiar, did a lot of just great rock and you know, rock albums, pop rock, if you will, southern rock at its, when it was his best, I think. I've got, you know, some vinyl back there and all that kind of good stuff, including his video, which was live. And this was a whole thing for me that turned me on to Mylon was the Live Forever cassette. I still have, this is an original from 83, I think, or 84. 83, Word Records Murr was the label at the time. So anyway, let's get cracking. I'm going to kind of shotgun through these pretty quickly, but I'm going to put a lot of song clips on here. So if you're interested in knowing what Mylon sounds like and what these different records sound like, here you go. Coming in at number 12, Big World. Big World is probably his hardest rocking record. Good record. Very produced. Very 1989, 88. Good album. Coming in at number 11, his debut Christian album, essentially. Stranger to Danger. Always liked that song, kind of a Doobie Brothers 70s kind of vibe. Coming in at number 10 off of Live Forever. Jesus is the Waymaker. Great song. Really wish there were more songs throughout the catalog, a whole record of that, right? Coming in at number 9, also off of Big World. Turn the Tables on Me, a solid offering. Very heavy, hard-edged, not heavy metal by any stretch, but high energy. And at that point, a lot of the regular Christian bands and artists were giving a heavier, rawer, edgier sound. Let's go coming in at number 8. 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, 0. No, so number 9. Sorry, 12, 11, 10, 9. Coming in at number 8. World Changer. Cool song off the Crank It Up album. I've seen it said World Changer, World Challenger. I hear the lyrics, I hear World Changer. You tell me in the comments below. Coming in at number 7. The crown of life will soon one day. I Will Rejoice from the Sheep's and Wolves Clothing album. Great song. Coming in at number 6. Crack the Sky. He was in this very 80s hyper-produced, a lot of sequencers, a lot of technology, very cutting edge at the time, but unfortunately nowadays very dated sounding, but a good song is still a good song. I Will Rejoice and Crack the Sky. Coming in at number 5. Gotta love Trains Up in the Sky. Very 1985. Again, hyper produced, dated, but a great song. Again, is still a great song. Coming in at number 4. Freedom from Live Forever, a great hard rock and driving tune. Freedom comes in at number 4. Coming in at number 3. Crank It Up was the title track off of his 1990 album by the same name, his last rock record. He's since gone, Mylon, you know, any musical output from this point forward has primarily been very gospel-oriented, more ballads, that type of thing. Coming in at number 2. A reworked version of a song he wrote some 20 years earlier, 15 years earlier, Gospel Ship off of Sheep and Wolves Clothing. Lots of guest stars on that. You could hear Russ Taff and Greg X. Voles and Kerry Livgren, I think, played a little on that album. A great song all the way around. My number one song, my favorite track from Mylon Lefevre, in my opinion, it's his heaviest song. It's one of his most groovy. It's off Alive Forever. I actually like the version off of the VHS a little bit more so, but it's all right. is my number one Mylan song, and here it is. Great tune. It's got a great hook. It's got a very late 70s, early 80s kind of prophetic, lyrical vibe to it. It was done by an outside songwriter. I think technically this might be a cover, but I think it's just someone else wrote the song and he did it. Favorite song of mine. And whenever I go back and listen to these old Mylan songs, it's really hard to believe. A lot of this stuff is 30 years old, 35 years old. It has impacted a lot of people, continues to impact people. I hope, what are your top 10? Give me your top 10 Mylan songs in the comments below. I hope you like and share the video. Again, this isn't a scholarly review. These are my top 10, my favorites. What are yours? Actually, it was a mulligan, did top 12, but that's all right. Right? Like the video, subscribe to the channel, share it. You know, love to hear your comments. Leave them in the sections below. Appreciate your support. And don't forget to say your prayers. And God bless.